Pastor said to.
So teamwork encourages employees to feel proud of their contributions. When you go for the meetings and they are the senior managers, kazi yako ni kungelia ama ni kucontribute. If you don't contribute, you are avoiding not valuable. Contribute. The CEO has an open door policy. I came to his office and he has a nice, of course, but I see you have a very nice office. I want to appreciate that I have been so many circles, and I told you when I came in, you have the best office that I've ever entered. Even the one I was consulting for was not your class. Your class is totally exceptional. You're exemplary nice.
Thank you.
Even your dressing code is good. You see, when you become a senior manager, my brother, you would not go buying a trouser that looks almost closer to the coat. You even your dressing portrays a level of a senior manager, am I right? You don't dress the same way with those other young ladies and girls. You don't dress a dress that's exposing your anatomy and your endowments, your body morphology, anatomy, and general physique. You've not just walked sluggishly, because you know, walking sluggishly does what? It becomes contagious to your colleagues. You walk with purpose, more than everyone, because you know what you're doing. And one man called Mr. Dr. Maus Munro said that the greatest tragedy in people's life is not death, but living a life without purpose. The CEO by now ought to have realized, what is your philosophy? What do you stand for? Do you stand for efficiency and effectiveness? Or do you actually settle for average? Are you an average performer? Are you one who's so concerned with what you call the outcomes or what you're doing? So tackling obstacles and creating notable work together makes team members feel fulfilled. When you have been given a task by the CEO, how do you interact? How do you exchange information? How do you come up with a solution? Who is the first one to send his opinions? Yes, because it matters. Everything matters. Remember I told you don't have the luxury of time. So time is of essence. You have dreams. You have set dreams. You have goals for the organizations. So those goals must be met by you people, not any other person. And remember, your power when loses him, trickles down to those people, Mr. Maina mkona wakule shini. Wakiona mkona kulekalega, ata wanafanya nini? Ni kama tu kwa boma, ukiona bwana yako anakuja saa 7 saa usiku na humuulizi swali, atakuja saa 8. The following day, atakuja kubadilisha nguo. Tunaona kesho. Na anaenda. You will reprimand him. Sweetheart. Past midnight. What? Is everything okay with you? You must show concern even to those people who don't work well. Ukisikia customers wana complain sana kule kwa tela, what do you do, Mr. Maina? That becomes a matter of concern, not necessarily to the CEO, because all you are all the eyes of the CEO. Will you call your supervisor? The one on the hierarchy of, I think your staff members are letting us down. Customers are complaining. What's up? And that's where you see sometimes we have come up with what you call the clocking times. Eh? The next customer, so that you can know in the evening, we do the analysis. How much time did you spend with one customer, am I right? And we need to know what was the issue with this customer that made you spend more than 15, 20 minutes. How many mutu alikupeda mnaogea mapenzi? How many wagino hako? Sweetheart, hey, you know, yako ni poa, ni fair date. Na bayangu ya simu 072, yako ni gani? Oh, wena na jumapili ya masa. Now, customers wako wapu muna. Na muna shaka pala. Na muna tanza na yaka kumaji, unakumia na style. Na customers wako wapi? Still, you know what? Do you know how bad it impacts on the organization? When the customers are complaining, what happens? The organization might crumble. Am I right? Mm-hmm. These are the days, gone are the days where one customer was carrying out 8. Nowadays, one customer carries the entire one. Do you know what we call social media? Avoid relationships as team senior managers. Don't have a, my brother, even if you see a beautiful girl who looks like a glass of wine, it is not meant for you. And I told this some other men, hata sija anaongo wa Kenya, mkikunywa pombe hapa, hii pombe ni yako, unaangalia ile iko kwa kaunta. Hii iko kwa glass ndio yako, ile iko kwa kaunta ni ya wengine. Yako ni gani? Ukunywe uende nyumbani, ile sio yako. Unajua watu wengine wanamsiana ameajiriwa. Naona dia anaanza kufanya moves. Sasa. We have been here for 14 years. You get last man. Talk to me. I know the systems. Ni acha mzuri sana. Otherwise, namba yako hapa. Hapo kifika kule kwa baba. Joyce. Tukutana wapi? Tuadhiye kuito mwea. Kako vikie. Rubbish old. You know, I've been telling people, the moment you enter relationships in an organization, that becomes the genesis of failure of an organization. There will be no valid contribution, am I right? Mm-hmm. Senior managers must be men and women of integrity and character. Am I right? What is character? Character is what you do when nobody is seeing you, apart from your God and yourself. Teamwork, believe you me, works. Working toward achieving, the company goes allows employees to feel connected to the company. You feel good when you see the, you know, when you see the CEO saying, we move from this level to the other. What do you think? It's what we call a going on concern element. You know you have a job, your job is secured. If you see the circle going down in terms of performance, you're also going down together with it. No man will be left standing. Trust builds loyalty. We talked about loyalty, am I right? Mm-hmm.
We must be loyal to the employer. We must be very, very transparent. We must be accountable. Whatever you have been given by the organization, use it well. Don't use your privilege to be bossy to other people. And remember, together as all in circle, what can we do? We can
do it.
Yes, we can do it. And Obama did not win the US elections because he was the richest. As a matter of fact, he never appeared anywhere in the Alexander Forbes of Risting. But he was wise. He used his brains and used other people. And he came up with a very good slogan. Yes, we can. And I'm saying we at all in, yes, we can do it. Teamwork is not just help for employees. It benefits the employer as well. Because when you work as a team, everything works. Am I right?
Yes.
So we are saying it is not only beneficial to you, but it also helps the employer in the long run as well. Employees that connect directly with their workplace are more likely to stay with the company. This is what we call HR manager. Where is he or she? Do you have the HR manager with us here? I have one. HR. So the HR manager, he or she is the one who knows the rate of turnover. If you see a company with a high rate of turnover, what does that one tell you? That the terms and conditions are not favorable. Either the people working in that organization are not friendly. They are actually not cohesive, am I right? So we are saying, if you see people working as a team, like now, Jane, you have been there for quite a long time. Even when you were with you in the college, you are still working with this, when it was called Muhei Yesako, if I'm not wrong. So you already understand. And the CEO talked about the culture of Asako. What is the culture of Asako? It has made you to remain. Maybe you have been offered other jobs elsewhere because I know you're aggressive, but you have said, Mimi Kuntaka wapi? Yes. Because Orin Sako has taken, you know, there's something called loyalty, feeling that you are part and parcel. When we talk about the achievements of your life, courtesy of Orin Sako, teamwork allows people to engage with the company and to add to the bigger picture. Like now, I know our ICT manager is actually, like now, I met one of the Sakos, which is called Tai Sako. I met Mr. Mwangi, the CEO. And believe you me, I wish you can have a talk with that ICT manager. Mm-hmm. I think they also have one of the best IT systems.
Okay.
Thank you so much. Yes. I have actually done a bit of what you call competitive analysis, and they are doing pretty well in terms of IT. You engage him further. Because I want Orin Sako, by the way, I told Mr. CEO Bonarahide, I told him I want Orin Sako to be the best Sako of choice. That even when they go for meetings for SASIDA, the person to be referred to is Mr. CEO. We see what pesa ya mari, kuponda mari ya kuna, integrity and character and transparency. And members, no member will be going to SASIDA to complain. I have not been given my loan, I have not been, you know. Why? So because the CEO and the team, you have a vision. You know what you want to do. You know what it takes. And you have the right people. And you have the right software and hardware with you here. So working as a team allows members to take more risks. What do I mean by taking more risks? You can even go on a Saturday when you've been given a platform to give a testimony. Unasema, mimi naitwa Beatrice Gare, nafanya na Orin Sako, tuko na mpago ya kufundisha watoto, ya kuweka pesa sa watoto, utaka road ya kujenga nyumba, tuko nao, na Yesu ni Bwana. What have you done? Haven't you marketed on behalf of Shaw? So, and of course you say, na mukitwaka kuna, unasema yongere, me, I market the companies have worked, we have marketed for one company called Empire Feeds. We have consulted for them now for 5 years. They are sales record. Mr. Gadoa is so excited. By the way, last year he sent us a bonus. We were given a bonus for not working, but for promoting 250,000 shillings for free. Imagine a company giving you for free, Mr. Mwemei, 250,000 shillings. He has never, we are the people who prepared his strategic plan. We met all his distributors. We spoke to the entire staff members, 800 of them, at a place called Gossip Center in Morongo. And thank God. And they were very happy because we were able to work together with them. I wanted people to work together with the CEO, the finance manager, the various heads of departments, so that Orin Sako can become the Sako of
choice.
What about, I repeat this word again. In order for us to achieve the set goals and objectives, what is required of us? One word, one big word. Commitment. Of course, we have the right leadership. We have Mr. Don't think that Mr. Kadige became the CEO of this Sako because he's a dark, tall, handsome man, six-pack. No, it's because of what is between his 2 years. He has aptitude. He has the integrity required of a leader. He has passed chapter 6, leadership and integrity. He has been tested and proven. Don't think that Mr. Maina is there because he's blown like a vision. No, he's there because he can be able to safeguard the interest of the circle. So leadership is there. Then what else do we have? Those who can be able to see. You know,
something called competence. Can you see that competence? We have people with the right competences. What about respect to their bosses? When Mr. Maina said, let us give our CEO a standing ovation, everybody stood. There are some organizations you can say so and everybody remains seated. But because you respect your CEO, and because the CEO has brought people in what we call, which other one can you see there? We have talked about leadership, we have that. Now, the CEO talked about what? Vision, where we want to go. Am I right? The CEO talked about people who have got what we call competencies. We are not talking about what here? People who have got what? And people who have what we call philosophy of hardworking, and over and above all, what are you doing now? What are we doing?
It's called capacity building.
If a good person, now I have already supervised 7 PhD students. That's also what made me to become a professor, an associate professor. And I've supervised 15 now master's students. I personally don't teach bachelors, they have their teachers. Me, I only teach masters and PhDs. Bachelors, they have their own lecture. And according to me, they will start me. So what I'm saying is that if you look at this diagram alone, this diagram Banashoba summarizes everything required in an organization with a set goal and objective. Am I right? Mm-hmm. Aren't we talking about leadership? Mm-hmm. Aren't we talking about skills, competences, respect, vision? We have the power and the will, and we have a very good board of management. We have leaders, and we have now what you call good leadership. So teamwork allows employees the freedom to think outside the box and embraces the spirit of commitment. You must be committed to your work. I'm still talking about, because let me tell you, Mr. Maina, the finance director, there is no way Odin Sako will go to those places. I want you to see the level of commitment. You know, I have done it deliberately, Madam Beatrice Gari. If you look at that odometer, where is the level of commitment? Thank you. You can see you have what we call low, moderate, and so where is it? In the region? Remember, in the normal distribution curve, we have what we call the rejected zone and the acceptable zone. Now, you see, we want what we call high level of commitment, working as a team every day. And I would also appeal to all of you, if you can't find your colleague for 1 or 3 days, call your colleague, my brother. Wow, are you okay wherever you are? Is everything adding up? Because you never know. That call, and I know we're going to see you if Mr. Maina never came any single day, even before he fails to come and have communicated to you the previous night. If you know you'll not be in the office tomorrow, what do you do? A good worker does what? Informs his colleagues, so that there will be no haphazard or ad hoc kind of plans being made. And I hope, Mr. IT manager, with all respect, you have somebody that you have nurtured, you have got your assistant people, people who can assist you in the worst case scenario. You don't give them, of course, all the credentials, but you have told them what they can do in case of an emergency. I remember one man who sabotaged a company in West Rights, and I can't call because the management was so strict. Let me surprise you something here. Unless you realize that you were hired for a purpose, you are here for a reason and for a purpose. Am I right? Yeah. You are not here because they want statistics of how many people. In fact, if the circle can operate with only 3 people, and it operates, the better for this man called finance manager. Because, you know, even salaries is a cost. Yes, even a graduate is a cost. You know, it doesn't mean it. Even you are coming here, I know by the end of the day you have third DM because of interference from your house. Because you have left your wife now, you know, they will take care. So, you see, you have to go on a baby, you have to keep. You have to keep. There's what we call the Sophia Lance play. But you see, Mr. CEO said, you know, I was very keen. He's spending off almost $1 million for your coming here. Even those cars that you see here, they have been hired, am I right? Mm-hmm. It's a cost in your book. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because you have to explain how was this cost incurred. So we are saying commitment is key. I don't have a lot of time. Let me move on because I have another area to cover. So as we move to the next area now, I want to ask you one question. You are... How many are here? You have such a good car. Not that I've come too late, but you have a good car. Oh, dear. She was taking care of the home. Alikuwa anachukua poka points. conclude on teamwork by talking of these two words, then we move on because I have only, I think I have only 1 hour. Is it 1 hour? 45 minutes. How many minutes do we have? Timekeeper, please. Who is it, Mr. Shop? Who is the timekeeper?
We are scheduled to go for game 12 by 5.
So I should be done by 10 to 5.
You should be done by, say, let it by 5.
Thank you, 5. 5, perfect. Ah, now I'm managing my time properly. Now, as I wind up my bit on teamwork, I think we have covered enough on teamwork.
As we do that, I request also we can be taking our tea.
Yes.
Not have
so that you know, that's what we do, by the way. We manage time because you are doing the listening, passive listening. Your tea should be there. So you take your tea, so that by the time the bell goes, you can talk about it. It's a request. And that's a very good point. And because I do not have any other time, this is one of my books. I hope, Mr. Maino, you have read this book, Demystifying Success. If you have not read, you bring it back, and I will not give the money to you. I have been solicited to you to go and meet. So I have a book which is called, Demystifying Success. I'm also the author of this book, which is called The Transformative and Authentic Leader of the 21st Century. Then after you have made the money, how do you balance your work? I have a book which is called Quality Work Life Manual. There are those people who wanted to know how I became a multi-millionaire, how I made a million when I was only 21 years of age. My book is here, which is called Defying All Odds, a true story, rising above adversities in life. The four books will go at 4,000. If you want three, 3,000, 2,000, and we go that way. If you want it, because by the time we are done, we shall not have any other discussion on this. Those are my books. I have written 11, but I only come with four. Why did I come with four books? Because I knew I was coming to Kenyans. You know the one thing with Kenyans, they don't love reading. During post-election violence, all bars were broken into, all boutiques were broken into, all butcheries were broken into, but nobody broke into a bookshop. All bookshops remained intact. You know that? What a bookshop is good. So efficiency and effectiveness. How efficient are you at your workplace? How do you manage the resources within your department? Because teamwork means you must also be aware of the resources given to you and how you use them. Am I right? Because your department misuse of resources has a direct impact on the balance sheet of Mr. Maina by the end of the year. When he's doing his IFRIS, and when he's actually meeting the GAAP, the GAAP, he's expected to highlight and tell how these resources were mobilized, how they were used. So are you efficiency? Efficiency in teamwork means you manage your time well. You manage the money with. Even when you have got so many customers, if you realize that your treasury has no money, doesn't have enough money, my brother, you don't tell customers to go empty-handed. You say, we have not projected to give out more than 5 million shillings today. So we are not, I know you wanted 100, but I'll give you 50. Because I have another customer who requires 20 then, but tomorrow I'll be able to give you, sort you out. So you must be efficient in how you use your resources. And the mode of using the resources available, efficiency is basically the modus operandi. How do you manage? What is the system? The how? Efficiency is proper utilization of resources available at your desk. And then effectiveness is basically the modus operandi, the way, the how you are using those resources to meet the set objectives in the organization. All right, we move on very quickly because I've got less than 30 minutes. We come to this discussion very briefly. People who don't manage their money well, it does not matter how much money you get paid by all in circle. If you're a poor financial manager, you remain a poor financial manager, am I right? The Bible says if you can't manage scarcity, you can't manage abundance. If you are petty, you can only manage petty cash. Petty people manage petty cash. So we need to look at a few things. When we talk about personal financial awareness and wealth creation, we need to look at your income. How much money do you earn? How much do you get paid every month? Then from there, we look at what we call, in that same income, we look at your spending habits. How do you spend your money? Do you have a budget? And remember, why do we prepare a budget? By the way, we don't prepare a budget because money has been put into our accounts. We budget even when money has not come into our accounts. So meaning that when resources come to your hands, you'll be efficiently manage them in the best way possible. If the best way possible is effectively. So what is your spending habit? Then how much are you saving? If you're a member of Odin Circle, are you a super saver? Do you believe in your organization? How much have you saved in terms of shares? How much do you have in terms of share capital? So if you don't have trust in your organization, then you have no business associating yourself with Odin Circle. Because the Bible says Jerusalem starts at home. So how do you save your money? How much do you save? How do you invest your money? Some of us, we don't invest our money. As a matter of fact, I wish we had enough time, I could have taken you through what we call the paying yourself first module. Do you pay yourself? How many of you pay yourselves? I know you, most of you don't pay yourselves. But I think I'll spend a few minutes there because it will summarize my discussion. And you know, because you know I'm a philosopher, and you, when you become a PhD holder, you philosophize. Philosophize means you have added a new branch of knowledge to that particular. Let me now summarize this discussion because I've got less than 20 minutes to go. Or there, let me summarize, Madam Mugati. All of you looking at me here, I'm summarizing my discussion, but you can have ample time to go for game drive. Now, looking at me, all of you, why are you at all in circle, all of you? We are talking about personal finance. Why are you at, Mr. Sob, are you telling me that you're in circle because you are all in circle so much? It's because of what you get paid. If that day is go no pay, another that has, so why they think you are working for Mother Teresa? Philosophy of philanthropy, not me. The idea for big one, muna kazi. So you are not at Orini Circle because number one, you love it so much. It is because of what you get paid, Mr. Mind. Yes. Let's be honest. Nobody loves working. By the way, my sister, if you had to go to bed and sleep and money comes your way, you could not have walked to Orini Circle. I think when the lady of a guy in Oka Bella, Mother Nihereji, Igoka. Jajaria Mother, your mother, the king, you are Goka. Your Gracia, Mother Nigasia, Igoka. You can't go to work. Nobody loves working. I'm telling you. So why do we work? Because I want to summarize on this issue of personal finance. I want a very quick answer, Mr. Shoba. Why do we work? We work to do what? To make? Then after we have made demand, I want you to follow this because this one will summarize my discussion so well. You know, because I will wear rights. Let there be darkness. So we work to make money. After we have made demand, what do we do, all of us? Use the right word. Yeah. Should use the accountant's word. So, Ms. So all of us work, and we work to make money. And after we have made money, what do we do? Same. Now, listen carefully, Madam Beatrice, my classmate. It is at this point of spending that we have the rich, note that, we have the average, and we have the poor. Oh my goodness. We have the rich, the average, and the poor. Now, some of you looking at me today, you spend all the money that you make. All. Not even that. To make the whole scenario worse, you even spend more than you earn. That is why some of you have got what we call normal loan, capital loan, salary advance, dividend advance, FORISA, MSHWARI, Okwa Jahasi, Shailoko. So you have not. So when you come to work, you are so demotivated. You are only money. Customers go there, not put your side. You see, when you spend all or more, you end up entering into the cocoon of what? Yes. We are not saying debts are bad. As a matter of fact, debt is what makes you people survive. Because you make money because of lending. So now here, it is between. We have what we call good debts and we have what we call bad debts. So good debts are devalued to you, bad debts devaluate you. Am I right? I don't have it to explain because I'm talking to educated senior members of the staff. Let me come to this because you're talking about personal financial. The other side that will take you within 5 minutes. There are some of us people who also spend their money, but they spend their money what? Why is it? What do they do that most of us people don't do? They do what we call they save. And those people who save, what do? They invest. And those people who invest, what do? They create wealth. And those people who create wealth, they go to the most desired destination, financial freedom destination. Financial independence destination. When you come here, you have the freedom to make what we call now what? What do? So when you go buying a car, you don't just buy a Probox, you buy a real automobile. You go asking for Porsche Cayenne, for Aston Martin, for Lamborghini, for Ferrari, Mercedes-Benz S-Class, Evolution. Those are the kind of cars that, because your children do not go to ordinary schools, they go to Blaiban High School. Am I right? Blaiban, IGSE schools, group of schools, not Mugano School. So here you have choices. And people who have choices, what do? When you come here, what will make you come here, basically because of time, it will be a product of two things. Number one, you must, rule number one, to be able to come here, you must learn to spend less than you earn. Why do some members of the staff get tempted to steal from the employer? why some members want to cook figures? Because they want to meet a certain threshold, but they don't have the income, am I right?
Yeah.
Because they have spent more than they do. They have done what? They have earned. If you spend more than you earn, where are you? Yeah. And most in bad debts. So, number two, you must learn to pay yourself first. Learning to pay yourself first means, you must also give yourself a value. When you give yourself a value, you'll be knowing how much money you're putting for your old age. You'll be knowing how much money you're putting into your development projects. You'll be knowing how much money you want to put for what you call even for your retirement. So how many surprises do you encounter in your life regarding your finances? Some of you, unexpected car problems. Your car battery has gone down. You have no money. Because you don't even have what you call buffer stock. You have no resources. You don't even save for a day in a day. You subscribe to Heiner philosophy, clearing and forwarding. How many times do you find yourself with medical bills, with school fees blown? How many times do you go for holiday with your family members? Like now, some of you never took your families for holidays because you said there was COVID. No, you have learned how to survive with COVID. So even going for holiday, you must survive with COVID. So how much have you saved for your family? Nothing. So what do you say? Are you a culprit of impulse buying? You go buying things that are not adding value. Gary, why do you have 50 cups in your house? Is your house a restaurant? So if you're a 5, buy 10 cups. Because they're not going to last in your house forever. Where do you waste your money? Why don't you buy more shares with your holding circle that will be giving you dividend by the end of the year? As opposed to having 50 cups that are not adding any value to you. Why do you have so many clothes in your wardrobe, yet you have missed one opportunity of becoming a Miss World? Why are you competing in a battle you have already lost? Why are you putting posters at you shaguliwe, BTS shaguliwe, IBC mesha declare anigration. And my goal was the governor for Kenya. Ukishindwa unatoa posters, am I right? So if you're already and you have gone beyond that, me becoming Miss World is like Kweragire to me. So why are you in a competition you have already lost a binisho? So, do you find yourself in cash crunches before your next payday? Are you the person who normally go to, you have salary in advance, dividends in advance, everything is in advance because you are living too large. Everything
is in
Because you see, and it's nothing as dangerous as borrowing money, am I right? Yeah. Without plans. So we are saying, what am I saying? Personal financial planning is basically a system whereby you know how much money comes your way, how much has been properly apportioned to given projects, and at what time and in which proportions. Personal financial planning. You must have financial goals. Like I had financial goals, I'll show you maybe before you call it a day. I have a school, which is now valued at 103 million shillings. As per Mr. Leon Masika's valuation in the month of February this year. The house I'm living in was valued in the month of January of insurance, 45 million shillings more. Anyway, I'm moving. When you manage your finances, it helps you prioritize the goals based on funds available. Even Mr. Miner, when he's paying the dividends, it is purely based on funds available. And remember, you have what we call retained earnings. We must have some retained earnings in our buffer stock. Why? Because there are some issues which are called emerging issues. Am I right? The systems may collapse and you require to upgrade. Am I right? There are many things that can happen. It gives you financial hygiene. Most of us people, we have got no financial hygiene. Most of us people, we actually have a lot of money to waste. Why do you have 5 phones in your house? Simultan. As more than the iPhone, you get an Apple secret. Why? A financial budget keeps you alert. It helps you track your expenditure, am I right? Very, very important. I'm highlighting because we don't have time. So benefits of personal financial planning, I'll just highlight the most important point. Number one, income management. You'll be able to manage your income and to manage it more effectively through a defined financial plan. So you'll be able to create a budget and therefore there'll be no shockers because you already know how much money you have and what are the projects at your heart. Number two, you'll be able to measure your progress. When you have got a very good financial goal and planning, you'll be able to measure your progress. Where are you in the year 2020? Why is the CEO saying that we require to have an asset base of 15 billion within a period of how many years? Maybe 4 years or thereabouts. So it will help you measure progress on your financial goals. Financial planning gives you financial understanding. Through a financial plan, you are in a better position to understand the financials through the set measurable financial goals and effects of decisions made. So at any one given time, you know where you are and where you have gone wrong and how to come back to the course. Because you have what we call financial understanding and the dynamics of money. Moving on very, very fast. You know, people know what are your assets vis-a-vis your liabilities. When you are looking at your assets vis-a-vis liabilities, what are you looking for? Net worth. Am I right? You are looking at your net worth. So you do what we call the net worth analysis. And how does net worth analysis even help owning circle? It will be able to know, like, you know, we talked of how many branches, 15 more branches or thereabouts. You have 8 so far, 7 so far, you require 8 more if I'm not wrong. So that is part of now what you're looking at. What will it translate to into overall financial picture of Odin Circle? So even at your individual level, just like Odin Circle is looking at the overall performance, you also look at your individual level, where you'll be in terms of your asset base. So what about emergencies? When you plan your money well, you'll be able to even have some money for emergencies. You must be having a medical card with you. You must be having your national hospital insurance card with you, which is actually up to date. Why? Because those are the emergencies that you take care of. If you have a car, you don't take a third-party insurance. You take a comprehensive cover. If you have got TVs, you have got deep freezers in your house, you have got what we call washing machines, you take a domestic package cover. If you have a laptop worth 100,000 shillings or a phone like mine, which I bought at 195, they were having a discount. That phone is actually Apple 7. They have not yet come to Kenya. They are only up for 6, so don't go looking for it now. You're wasting your time. Just go through the internet order from Japan. So we are saying, you know, be able even to insure your gadgets against theft. Why? Because you know the value of that. So emergencies, many say savings are cushioned for rainy day. However, sudden financial changes can still throw you off track. Am I right? Yeah. If your savings are not, it is always good to have some investments with high liquidity, near cash, that you can be able to convert into near cash in terms of a treasury bill, treasury bond, in terms of what you call, can even have shares, can even have what you call a portfolio account, among others. I'm moving, I want to be 5-4 minutes. Now, benefits of financial planning very, very fast. Number one, it increases your savings, because when you know how much money you have, you avoid wastage. Am I right?
Yes.
It increases your savings. I want to read the contents. I'll send these notes to my brother, Mr. CEO. Number two, you enjoy a better standard of living, because you know how much money. Do not live as per people's perceptions. Because people think because you work in a bank, you are the person in charge of treasury. Your money belongs to all, money is yours, all of it. They do not know you have a payslip by the end of the day. So it will make you lead a better life, because you already know how much money to allocate to all the projects that you have. With a good financial plan, you do not need to compromise your lifestyle. It is possible to achieve your goals with living in a relative comfort. Number three, you will be prepared for emergencies. You'll be able to create what you call an emergency fund. As a matter of fact, as financial coaches, we normally recommend you must be having at least 6 times of your gross pay at any given time. If not that, ensure that you have all the safeguards in place just in case an emergency came. You'll be able to attain a peace of mind. Do not be surprised, because you understand your finances. You know what is your net. If your net is 30, you'll be living within the margin of that, not 60. Am I right? So you'll be having what you call a peace of mind. Do not live large, because you are in charge of the treasury. Now, how to create a successful financial plan purely depends. You require some time to sit down with us as financial consultants, and we help you to plan your finances. And now, within 2 minutes, let me show you a few pictures of how good it is to manage your money well, because time was not on our side. For, of course, write down your financial goals. You need to ask yourself which is your priority. If you have got children, you require to have some money set aside for your children's education. If you are 50 years, you must ask yourself whether the money will be paid by all in sum will be enough to meet your financial requirements as expenditure. So look at different investment options, because there are several of them. Look at where you need to invest your money and why you should invest your money there. Of course, not ignoring the element of risk exposure. You must have what we call risk mitigating factors in place so that your money is not exposed. Implement the right plan. Don't do what others are doing. Look at the portfolio. Talk to an expert. They'll be able to guide you on where which areas to put your money in with very low chances of risk. Then monitor your financial plan regularly. Keep monitoring how your money is doing, so that you may be able to address the areas that might be leaking. Then another aspect of financial planning, Mr. Minder, which I know maybe you have not done, is that we recommend you write a will. Financial planning involves writing a what? Why? Because those people who die without a will, they die intestate. Intestate. Those who die with a will, they die testate. Very, very important. I'm a lawyer. I can help you craft. I have already written my will, highlighting all my wealth, including the house that I have in South Africa, Lubumalanga. So you do you dream of driving this kind of a car? Yes, I know some of you looking at that car. It's not a bad car, a truck. Of course, when the CEO drives this kind of a car, everybody realizes the chief executive officer, stroke president, all in circle has aligned. This is one of my cars, by the way. This car, I bought it in the year 2009. I no longer drive it. I have given it to my daughter because it is actually a 2.7 liter. I'm not driving a 4 liter petrol. Did you have diesel? So I don't drive that. So I wait now. And in the interest of time, because it's actually 2:05, I could have shown you more, but we've been told by even the steamer, time back. It is only 5 minutes to time. So we should stop there. I think we should stop. Yes? So. That's it? You wanted to see those then?
Yes.
So I'll be showing you some. Okay. We have his IT. Very fast because I have only 2 minutes to Marisa him Kutano. But anyway, I hope you have learned a lot on teamwork. Are we together on that one?
Yeah.
You have also learned a few things on financial planning and what you need to do and why you work. Am I right?
Yeah.
You don't just work to eat. You work also to create posterity for tomorrow. Am I right? Mm-hmm. I think this thing is a bit old. It's coming. It's coming back. Eh? So we do get it done. So, I'll show you. I think I'll show you my some of my investments to see what I have done. I'm not proud. If you see my investments, please, I'm not doing it to show you how much I'm worth. Anyway, as a matter of fact, I will not display my house in Karen. I will not display my house in Luda. So what let me be saying a few things before we call it a day. How now to have a risk-state degrees as an employee? A risk-state degrees are, number one, you must be in tandem with, thank you. Okay, thank you so much, my brother. So anyway, as I show you a few things, by the way, I'm not proud, but I'll be showing you because you're my friends. Remove those mandishi because you are the one who knows which one. Allies go. Now he goes out. So anyway, because I'm my brother, be blessed. And because you have been so good to me, let me be good to you.
Yes,
so let me,
yes, yes.
I'll give you one book for free. Don't pay.
Thank you so much.
And then the other two or three will buy anything. You cannot be given anything. Even the Holy Communion, you better eat and offer it. Thank you so much, my brother.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Good hard work pays. He has already. Clap for him! So this is the car I ordered, by the way. I ordered this car in Japan. Yeah, this is the car, by the way, but I see all this car. It's supposed to be at, when is it coming, Gloria? It's actually not more than 3 weeks from now. So I'm not changing from my plan of the according KZJ, you know them, not to this one. So next time. So this is me. Whom am I talking to, by the way? These are the kind of people that I talk to. Okay, this is Dr. Patrick. And you can, anybody who knows, a picture speaks a volume. Look at the eyes of every eye. Hey, look at this eye, guy. Look at this. Look at even the other person behind. It was because I was raising very, very pertinent questions on physical and monetary policy to the person who mattered. So, when I talk about money, we are talking about the medium of exchange. Am I right?
Yes.
It feels good to have what?
Money.
To have money. Let's work for money. This is the house I built at age 25, Mr. CEO, by the way. Even Mr. Maleti came, the CEO of New Fortis came to. I built this house in the year 19. Maybe you did. You never came to my place. I think your classmate. This is the house. I don't live here. It's a 5-bedroomed house. On a garden, in a bedroom. Yes, here. Even the cars, they have their own bedrooms. If I was living in this kind of house in the year 1998, which kind of house do you think I live in now? Discussion for another thing. This is my college, Mr. CEO. I built this college in Nairobi. I'll show you who opened my college because of time. This is which is called Panorama College of Business Studies. Studying on now 3.5 acres on my own in Nairobi. Imagine the capital city of Kenya. Of course, I have got several houses. If I'm coming from Naivasha, usiku uigie, na the selections garden, that is now in Karen, next to Kenya Defense College. Eh? But I have a small house there worth 55 million. So if I'm coming from Thika Road, this is now my college. Yeah? So you can see how beautiful it is. How does it look like? That's my college, by the way. You can see, Mr. CEO, that's my other car which I bought from Toyota Kenya at 5.7. They had a discount. Actually, they were having what you call a sale. So this is what you call the company latest. It's my car.
That's my college. Who opened my college, by the way? Look at who opened my college.
Yes.
That's the guy who opened my college. Yes. By Dr. John Hoover. He did. I'm the one, by the way, he graduated after he had graduated. He was 3 years later. I'm the one who owed him the academic regalia. This is me with my Range Rover, Mr. C. You may not be familiar with this. This is my Range Rover, which I normally drive over the weekends. Especially not on very dusty roads. As you can see here, I was a very good man. Because we will make money live well, am I right?
Yeah.
Make money live well, enjoy. I was trying to order this one for my wife on her birthday next year, but I plans are that way. So in life, my brothers and sisters, never ever. We don't spend a minute in Max because of time and everything. May God bless you and organize now or organize later. Any questions? I'm done. God bless all of you.
Thank you.
Any questions from the floor? Please, one or two. It's exactly 2 minutes to five. And I know you want to take it to help. By the way, the game drive is very good between this hour now. Before they speak, any question at least?
I just appreciate you for the session.
Thank you so much.
It has given an impact into my life.
Alright. You give glory to God. Mm-hmm. My sister?
Just to appreciate the session. And God bless you as a shuja. Thank you very much. And I'm happy to shoot you.
Thank you so much. God bless. I'll be coming to Angu. Well, I already have one way. Who sent me a card? Not to be a skim show, but who made the arrangements. My brother, any question?
I see my appreciations for.
Thank you. Thank you so much. My brother from Kemana, any question? Is it clear? You have understood teamwork and financial planning a little bit? Thank you, Brother Shoba.
Yes.
Any question because of time?
No. Thank you.
Thank you. My sister? Wonderful. I'll come to you later. CCB, is it? I'm a CCM. CCD, credit control department. Okay. Don't you worry. Any question, my brother?
No question,
my brother. My sister, internal auditor. Thank you. Mr. Bowen,
you motivated me to go back to reading.
Thank you, Karim. Now I'll go to my sister, the one who has been serving us. Any question, anything that you want to say before I invite the deputy president? Protocol means I invite the deputy president, who will later on invite the head of the state. Any question?
I don't have a question. I appreciate you. Karim
Sana.
Thank you. Also motivated us.
Thank you.
And I was just wondering, how do you manage to juggle all the businesses and.
That's a question I have received, by the way, in many forums. Very same. Of course, I go to class. Like now, I'm starting my second PhD. I go to class between Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. It's called intensive. Working days, I work between 8. I wake up at 4 a.m. in the morning. Then I stop work. I was talking with the CEO yesterday at 9 when I was leaving my office. I was still organizing other things. So it's about managing time and having time for the family. Like now, they know in December, I'm taking them to Baden, Durban. I've already paid Marimba, 155,000 aircraft. So with those many remarks, anyway, thank you so much, my sister. But to understand that one more, you need to read this book. Defying All Odds, A True Story, Rising Above Adversity's Life. And more so, to understand that, after the 68th day, Quality Work Life Manual, a case study of Dr. Kebicho. It is now my humble duty to invite Mr. Maina, the Minister Treasury. My classmate, Madam. Sorry, Madam Beatrice Gary. Within 1 minute or two, she was my good friend. So Malaysia, she was a very good lady, cooperative, a team player. Na hapo na wifu mpaka kwa class, mkuu na kwenye mazabu. So although I became a professor before, you don't worry, the classes are still open. So there's now my chance to invite you to say one or two words. Then Mr. Maina, then we go to the CEO. Over to you, Madam Beatrice Gary.
Thank you very much, Dr. Kebicho. I take this moment to say that. I'm really grateful for what you've been able to share with us. And I'm also challenged because there was a time when we were at far, but now I've realized people have moved. I remember when you used to traverse Kirinyaga County looking for teachers for insurance. The first used to be to work with an insurance company. And it used to be number one always. And in fact, that time he was still going abroad for his awards and he used to show us. And I've seen we kept the faith. And I promise that we will be able to move this institution far. In fact, I'm a very loyal customer to this institution. It has made me the way I am. But we'll talk later. Thank you.
We appreciate Madame Bill to transmit. Another one. It is now my singular duty to invite the second in command in the organization, Bana FM, to say one or two words, and thereafter, kindly ask our able CEO to close this meeting officially. Over to you, Mr. Maina.
Thank you. Thank you, Bana Consultant. We can also appreciate him the way he has done us. We got a lot of energy and
you have met my expectation beyond what I was expecting. I'm very happy. You can be assured, you can be assured that you will continue working together with us. I would wish that you be part of our any support family. Already you are. You said that you already is you are our member and you are and you're happy. But also want you to also work on my account. Mm-hmm. And if the account is open, it's Madame Bingwa, the question should be for that. I know you want it.
Yes, of course.
I know that I'm
going to go. The next step is to
be paid through his account. And I've been told the next check should be paid through the next. Yes. Yes. So, the management has spoken.
It's very spoken.
So, as I give you the next assignment,
yes.
The mode of payment is through.
So,
accounting for Kuriwe, you have to put it at that. Accounting for Kuriwe, so that I can be able to move on. I tell you to tell you, I'm going to tell you for more here. We keep on working with you, and especially on marketing. Especially on marketing. And I know you're able to really help us push our numbers. I would wish that we invite you so I can be part of our vision 2025. So we have our marketing and so forth. I've been following you, like I said. I've been following you, like I said. I've been wishing that my team also be following me through the social media. They are quite, you know, myself. They're very nice. Like you know, I think you're out 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
You're in the show.
Yes.
I think they're in all, right?
No, no,
yes. They're in all. I thought not that you didn't have some new book. You know what I'm saying? CEO are only very happy. Now, isn't it?
Yeah.
No, when you mention the CEO, what does that one mean? You mention the CEO and the circle. The CEO and
the circle.
So I go up the circle. So follow him through the social media, through the books. Yes, through the YouTube and so forth. I think that you're getting to work in a commanding Noro and any other media house,
right?
Yes. Let these people know. He's very, very exciting. He speaks very spoken, you know. Or even more exciting when he's there. And I have to watch him. So Dr. Ali, you're really there, okay? We continue following you. Let us buy his books. Let us buy his books. I have those 3 books with me. And he has got so many others. You know, every other day, Mr. Boy, you can pick a book. Now, maybe out of the 54, 100 pages, you only read one sentence, and that is what we call paradigm shift. That is why it is so good that we be readers. Leaders are readers. Leaders are
readers.
In fact, you cannot be a reader if you're not reading. That is for sure. If the last book that you read in the year to Mr. didn't fall apart, then I think you're out of touch. So you need to keep on reading and so forth and so forth. So that time we really appreciate you so much. We are so happy. We are delighted that you be together with us. And I assure you, we will continue working.
Okay.
Thank you. So I want to request now Carl, appreciate him officially, very briefly though, and then conduct a very, very formal now crafting so that the time can still appreciate you. Sorry.
Thank you,
Professor.
Good evening, everyone. It's an honor to be in this forum. Thanks to our CEO. And thanks to the board of directors in the office of the CEO. It's such a privilege. I've been watching Dr. Benicio during the television. It's now a privilege that I've met him in person. And he has talked on very pertinent issues that I believe all of us can really agree on what he has talked on, about teamwork, of which we are here so that we may be able to build a strong team, that we may be able to take Corinne where it deserves, and also about personal development and financial management. Well, Dr. Kibisho, we really appreciate you and all what you've taught us, we believe that you put into practice and that even as Orin grows, we are still going to be able to grow. Thank you so much and may God bless you.
Mm-hmm.
Let's all stand up so that we may appreciate you. Tafungua, tuipambe maua, then tuagushe mara moja.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
So thank you. Maybe as the financial director, the next page, I'm coming really.